Welcome back for another video. My name is Adam from WP Crafter, where I make videos for non-techies. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can move from one web hosting provider to a different web hosting provider. Now, if you've been following my channel for any time, you know that I strongly suggest going with InMotion Hosting. In fact, I'll have a link to InMotion Hosting down below. And you also probably know that when you do sign up through InMotion Hosting through my link, you get a bigger discount than what you see here. And I also give you access to my paid course library completely for free. But that's not what this is about. It's about how to transfer from one web host to another web host. Now, there's two parts to this. The first question is, where are your domain names registered, your website names? Now, some people don't realize you could have that at one company and your web hosting at a different company, and that's totally fine. So that's one piece of the puzzle. And the other piece of the puzzle is all your existing stuff, all your existing websites and email configurations or whatever you have going on with your existing web host, getting all of that moved across. Now, with your domain names, if you're just moving from one host to another for the hosting side of your website, you can leave your domain names at the old host if that's where they are, or you can easily transfer your domain names anywhere you want to transfer them to. You don't have to have them with your web host. In fact, I don't have them with my web host. This way I can be more mobile when it comes to web hosts. So I register all of my domain names at a website called Namecheap.com. I'll also put a link down below to Namecheap.com, or some people use GoDaddy. Now, those companies also sell web hosting, but I don't like to use their hosting because I don't find them quite as good. I've had an excellent experience with InMotion. Now, with InMotion, and particularly one of their line items when you're looking at their features, is they have a no downtime website transfer. And what this means is they're going to transfer everything for you, but it's limited to 3 transfers. And what that means is 3 websites or 3 databases or something like that, or also what's called 3 cPanel accounts. Now, the thing we have working in our favor when moving from one web host to another web host is that pretty much the standard industry control panel for all web hosts is called cPanel. Now, HostGator has cPanel, Bluehost has cPanel, iPage has cPanel, all these big names, they have something called cPanel, and InMotion is using cPanel as well. What you need to do to move from one web host to another is as simple as getting a backup of your cPanel account. Now, lots of cPanel accounts that you might have with the various hosts, there's going to be a backup option in there to generate a full backup. And all you have to do is generate a backup, download the backup to your computer, upload it to the new web host, and send them a ticket saying, "Hey, I put the backup on my account. Can you restore that backup?" And it's as simple as that. Once that's done, that's going to move all of your websites, all of your databases, all of your email configurations, all of that in one file, move it right across. And that is the fastest and most efficient way of doing it. Especially here with InMotion, if you request a transfer, sometimes they get a little backlogged. And if you say, "I want to transfer, here's my cPanel login," then what they've got to do is they've got to log in, make that backup, upload it, and all that. And they get a little bit of a backlog where it might take a couple days. Now, if you want it done a lot faster, you can go to your host, you can get this backup. And if it's not obvious how to generate it, I'm going to show you how to generate one. But if it's not obvious with your host, you can ask them, "Hey, can I get a backup of my cPanel account?" And they'll generate a backup and give you a link to download it. And then once you've downloaded it, all you have to do is upload it to the new host. So let me show you how to do that. So I'm going to scroll up here, and here is where I'm logged in with InMotion. And there's an option here to go into my cPanel account. Now, no matter who your host is, you're probably logging into your cPanel account. you know the login, you know the link and all that kind of stuff to log in. Now with InMotion, this is the pretty much the default look of the cPanel. Some of the different hosting providers will have a different look to it because you can actually choose how it would look. So this is how it is with InMotion, but I can change it to this thing called Paper Lantern, and I go like that, and it's going to have this kind of a more modern, fresh look to it, but it's the same thing. It's just an updated interface. So right here, you can click on Backup, or what I like to do is just click on Backup Wizard. So let's go ahead and click on Backup Wizard right now. So it takes you here, and there's just a couple steps to creating this backup. First thing we do is we click on the backup button, and then it's going to take us to step two, and then you're going to want to click on full backup. So let's click on full backup right now, and then it's going to take me to step three. So right here it's saying, where do you want us to put this backup? And then it's going to say, where do you want us to notify you of this backup's completed and ready to download? And this is where you just pop in your email address. So you can leave this as the home directory. That's what I would do. And then go ahead right here and put in your email address. Click on Generate Backup. And then it might take, depending on your host, it might take a minute. And also depending on how big the file is going to be, it might take a minute, it might take 10 minutes, it might take 30 minutes, but you'll get an email notification when it's ready to download. And then all you're going to have to do is download this backup. So I'm actually not going to do the backup because I don't want to generate one right now. I'm going to go back here. Now what you want to do is when you have that backup, so if you're moving to InMotion from HostGator, Bluehost, or iPage, GoDaddy, whatever host it is, when you're moving to InMotion, now what you want to do is click on where it says File Manager, and then we're going to now upload this backup to InMotion. So when you click on File Manager, it's going to take you here, and it's going to immediately put you in what's called the home directory. And then when you're here, all you have to do is click on this Upload button, and then you can drag and drop that backup file right here, and then it's going to upload it. So the upload limit, though, is 1 gigabyte. So if you're not familiar with sizes and if it's 1 gigabyte or less, you can first try to upload it, and then if it errors out, you know your file's larger than 1 gigabyte, and then you have to upload it through something called FTP. Now, uploading it through FTP is just a little bit more complicated, unfortunately. Maybe I'll save that for another video on how to FTP into your website. But most people, their cPanel accounts are going to be under a gigabit in size, and you can easily upload it this way. And then what you do once you've uploaded it, all you have to do is contact InMotion through a support ticket or whatever web host you have and say, I just uploaded my cPanel backup. It's in the home directory. Can you restore it for me? And usually, I know with InMotion, they'll restore it within, for me, it was usually within 4 hours they have it fully restored. So instead of waiting for them to go and log into the old host, generate the backup, download and upload it, and restore it, you're cutting out like 3/4 of the work in doing it for them, where all they have to do is restore it. So it happens a lot quicker. You don't have to wait in that long queue, maybe 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 days, when someone has the time to go in there and do all these steps for you. You could instead do it this way, and it ends up being a whole lot faster. And this is how you can move and migrate from one web host to another web host. It's a real simple process. And that's why you always want to use a web hosting provider that is using cPanel, because it makes it really easy to move around if you needed to move around. So anyways, that's all there is in this video to migrating from one web host to another web host. And if some of these technical things have been a bit complicated, like generating a backup, all you have to do is ask your old host, hey, can you give me a backup? And they'll do it for you. I've done that before. So that cuts out a little bit of the techie type of work. But then you still will need to upload it to the new provider. So Hey, before you go, I have something for you, and before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video, and if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm gonna give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.